North Face makes some of the best outdoor goods in the industry, and they're constantly looking at ways of changing up what's happening out there. So this year is probably the biggest game changer yet. They're bringing about a totally new membrane called FutureLite. It's a new membrane that we're going to be using in all their Summit series this year. It's over twice as breathable as its main competitor, keeping their waterproofing to the highest level possible. It feels soft and supple and comfortable to wear like a soft shell. They use a very clever process called nano spinning, and they can vary the thickness of the material. So lighter, softer, more packable layers for breathability and movement. To thicker, more durable, more robust endurance-based fabrics, which we use in the high mountains in really harsh conditions. They've launched it into their Summit series for this year, which is always the pinnacle of what can be achieved with outdoor goods, really based for high mountain sports and activities. This is the L5 Lite waterproof jacket. It's really thin, incredibly breathable, packs down tiny, and I think people would be using this on big mountain adventures when you're moving fast in the hills, maybe big alpine ridges, 6,000 meter peaks. We're really keeping moving hard, and breathability is key, as is weight. I've used this for running in now, but also the climbing is amazing, as you can raise your arms, there's no lift, the fit is incredible. It's got a full feature set, helmet compatible hood, big map size pockets, nice pull cords down the bottom. So this is the L5 Pro. I've probably tested this more than any other jacket we've ever made a video for before. I've been using it for over a year, starting in Zermatt last winter when North Face took us there to ice climb and to ski. Everything about it ticked all the boxes. It's breathable, it's durable, it's waterproof. When I took it to Scotland last winter, it got probably the best test ever. We had a beautiful climbing day and climbed quite a hard route. And I felt free to move, but comfortable. I had my nice guidebook pocket. But the real test came the next day when we walked into Black Crags. It was chucking it down with rain, the humidity was high, it was wet, but I just felt really comfortable. I didn't get overheat, I kept completely dry. All my friends were getting crinkly in their normal waterproofs and getting a little bit damp inside. It made me wish all my waterproofs were made out of FutureLite that day. We went for a hill walk afterwards and it was comfortable and breathable. Everything about this jacket is ideal for winter climbing. Burly face fabrics, incredibly breathable, waterproof, amazing cut and fit when I'm raising my arms. Soft and pliable so I can climb hard and not feel like I'm being restricted. And the hood is really secure. So quite possibly my favorite of all these items is the L6 synthetic belay parka. It packs down smaller than most belay jackets I've used, but it's at least twice as warm as the main ones you might have heard of before. I was blown away while using this in Scotland last winter. For a real test, I lent it to my friend Henry, who went on a big trip to the Andes. He was climbing 6,000 meter peaks and they did not get ideal weather. He was stood on the top of one of the mountains with light snow, rain falling on him, and was really impressed at the fact that the actual membrane is waterproof in this. They may not have taped the seams, but it's going to be more waterproof than most jackets you can get out there. And the warmth that's trapped in there because of it being a waterproof fabric just makes it much warmer than anything else. And as normal, all the feature set is perfect. Two-way zip for belaying and a really cozy hood. So quite possibly the most impressive and most important thing about this whole range of products we've got to show you is the fact that it's over 90% recycled and PFC free. So if you can't choose this jacket or the other ones we've looked at for the reasons that the higher performance, the breathability, the product, the feel, the testing, the hoods, the zips, everything that works perfectly, then why not choose it for ethical reasons? We produce a lot of goods for the outdoor industry and we really need to think about choosing our products wisely, and looking after them and making them last.